my friends. Welcome to another Subie Shaves video with me on a beautiful day. Hashtag Team All Blade and hashtag No Blade Left Behind. You know I've got to say it. Subie smiles to all of you and squad goals. Thank you so much for tuning in and for being here. Hopefully wherever you're watching from, you've got yourself something cold in your hand and you're ready for a beautiful shave. I know I am. I'm super excited. Come on in and let's do it. I'm thrilled. Today we're going to be talking about two razors that are getting the spotlight for September. We've got the Avenger here that from Shield in the brand new variation with a smaller head, polished by me, going up against the Yaqi Remulus, or the polished Artist Club razor that just barely came out in stainless steel. The razors, spec-wise, are different, right? This has got less blade gap, and it is heavier as a stainless steel razor. This razor right here, full titanium, GR5, both absolutely beautiful, and I'm really excited to see how they shave side by side. Again, this is being done because I've been asked like 25 times now how these two shave side by side. We just did the video with the two Shield Avengers going head to head, and then everybody literally right afterwards said, hey, give us the other one. We want to see how the Yaqi Remulus shaves compared to the Shield Avenger. Let's do it together today. I'm doing this for you, so if you haven't, go below, smash that sub button, smack a like, and let me know in the comment section that you're enjoying the content. I really do appreciate it. Let's do it together today. Oh, it's going to be awesome. We're going to be talking a little bit about the brand new, it's brand new to me at least. This is an Arianna and Evans scent that just barely-ish released. Mafioso's Retreat. I'm really excited to see Peter doing this one. This is a scent based on JPG LeBeau. And I'm going to say based on, I want to really clarify that because this is not actually a scent that was produced using a blend. I was able to sit and talk with Peter actually face to face directly. I talked to him about the scent. I said, you know, can you give me some insight into the scent? Because I really like this. It's aquatic. It's got this ozone, a little bit of ocean, a little bit of salty sea breeze is what I get out of the scent. With some pineapple, I get this citrus note that just punches you in the face and then intermixes really nicely with the aquatic notes. I said, this is great. Where can I buy an EDT of this? He said, well, actually, you know, I didn't use a scent blend because it was too expensive to purchase. He's like, you know, I'm not spending a ton of money to just get the decanter of scent blend. He's like, I'm not going to do that. I just blended it by nose, which takes some skill. He goes, you know, I'm not exactly right on the money for the scent, but I like where it landed. I do too. I think this is fantastic. Mafioso's Retreat, really beautiful one, based on kind of similar to JPG LeBeau. Really cool scent. Again, the lather today was just absolutely fantastic. Beautiful quality. And today I'm running it a little bit heavier, a little denser, a little less hydrated, if you can believe that. This is actually running my lather a little thicker than I usually tend to run it. But I love this new Ultima base. It takes a ton of water, but you can actually leave it a little less hydrated. And I get this really nice painting ability. Oh, I love this. Just releases from my brush really easily. And today we're using a Mountain Hair Shaving. Absolutely beautiful brush that Jeremy turned for me. And our Phoenix Artisan Accoutrement Scuttle. Awesome gear. Absolutely awesome. Beautiful lather. And today, as far as the splash goes, we're running Vita. I know you're sitting there saying, why? I want to mix that kind of citrus note from Vita with the aquatic notes from JPG's LeBeau. I think it's going to be a really nice pairing. Let's start the shave and then let's talk about it. I love the Shield Avenger razor. It's one of the ones that I have just had a hard time putting down since it arrived at my door, to be honest. I love the shape. I love the design. And I actually have been following a bunch of forums of people kind of talking about them. And the constant thing that comes up is, how do the two shave side by side, right? Has anybody used the Romulus, the Remulus? Has anybody used the Vector? And has anybody used the Shield? How do they all compare? It's interesting how, you know, this design very similarly, right, to the Vector, and how they all do kind of shave differently. You can see from the Yaqi, right, it has a thinner head cap, and you can see the trajectory down to the blade is slightly different than the Shield, right? The Shield has more of a, like a drop off. The Shield has more gap and more exposure than the Yaqi. At least I believe it has more exposure from the way it feels on the face. The face shave was phenomenal. It was really close, really comfortable. I love how the Shield gives you a little bit more angle, it feels like, because there's more blade to work with, right? That's just my perspective on it. I feel like the Shield razor has a little bit more ability to change the angle because you have more blade to work with and more gap to work with. Versus versus the Yaqi, where if you're on the right angle with this razor, it is a smooth driving, absolutely stubble eliminating razor. But for me, I actually had to almost find the correct angle and then go with it. Whereas the Shill just kind of finds the right angle right from the get-go because it has more exposure, at least for me. That's for me on the face shave today. Let's find out how it does on the dome. Today we are on 4 days, just over 4 days of growth. That is correct. You saw it take it down on the neck. That is four freaking days eliminated, down, destroyed. One pass, no problems. We did do the battle pass. I really ended up finding both razors, kind of picked up a little bit from each other after when I did the battle pass. So I honestly don't think either razor could be like, I couldn't decide which one was closer. To be honest, both were comfortable, both zero nicks, as we learned last time. Zero nicks, no dings, no irritation whatsoever. Just a beautifully comfortable, very, very enjoyable shave from the two Artist Club razors, at least so far. Let's get this thing going and let's see how it does with the Shield Avenger. Now, the interesting thing to me is just recently a friend of mine said, hey, Subie, you got to see this, and posted a link of somebody talking about the Yaqi Remulus on Reddit and how it compared to the Vector for them. They also had a Vector that binded up, right? They were mentioning they had purchased a Vector originally and it bound up on them, and that they believed that the new Yaqi Remulus, right, shaved way above its price tag. And I think that's almost something that's kind of difficult for the community to grasp, that you don't have to spend a ton of money to get a great shave. And I feel like that is something that's not really talked about or discussed in the community very often, right? We all think that the more money we spend, the better the razor is going to shave. For me, that's not really been the case. I feel like it almost is the opposite, right? There's definitely a bell curve where the little bit, zero money gets you nothing, right? But then there's like a sweet spot for excellence. And then I almost find like as you spend lots and lots of money, it almost taints your perspective of the shave because you're always saying to yourself, well, it should shave better than the money I spent, right? That's just my perspective. That's how it's been for me, right? As I spend more and more money, I am less and less satisfied with the overall shave. Just something I have found. I find that the Yaqi and the Shield razors really hit the sweet spot for the price, if almost unrealistic, right? This is under $100 for GR5, and you saw how fast and how easy 4 days came off, right? That was 4 days. We are using the Kai MG blades. These are the black, man, it's crazy. The black and yellow blades, absolutely beautifully smooth blades. The Pro Touch MG from Kai. I really like these blades. And I think these are the blades that actually come in the Shield, right? The Shield ships with the blade, and at least mine did. And I asked him, and he said he shipped it with the MGs. Very smooth, very easygoing razor, small head. Another thing that kind of came up, because when the person mentioned that their razor got locked up, right? Shane actually got in there. The Blackland said, you know, we would like to work with you. You know, they obviously are trying to figure out a way to remedy some of the issues with their T-bar design and the small head cap. Who knows? All I know is that the Shield razor does not bind up the blade anywhere inside the head cap. I prefer that. I prefer a razor. Even though Shane mentioned, you know, he's the innovator in the space, which is true. Really behind the design that really stands behind both of these. And I don't want to get too far in the weeds here, but really is we can all thank them for the amount of R&D and effort and energy they put into their design, right? But they are different. And I do believe that even though there's some differences in there's no differences in the closure mechanism, right? The screw, the square screw, I agree. I absolutely agree. I think the square screw is very unique to their design originally. But other than that factor, these do shave differently. I think the actual performance here showcases that, right? These two razors, even side by side, feel very different. And that was kind of another point that this person made, was that the razor for them shaves differently. And I think that's really the case. I think we're all looking for the razor that shaves best for us, regardless of the price, right? I think that's just a personal thing. I really, really like the Shield. The Yaqi razor for me, if you ever use the Excalibur, I feel like this is a huge, massive upgrade over their Excalibur. Look at all the lather just coming off my head. It's crazy. We're knocking it down. I think the Yaqi Excalibur and the Yaqi Remulus and Romulus actually are very similar, but the Romulus and the Remus, however you want to call it, I think it has better tolerances. I think it's a better razor. I think it's made nicer. I think everything on the razor closes tighter. For me, the stainless steel razor, the product that's produced in stainless, is a much, much better tolerance-wise razor and spec-wise razor. I think that they've really upped it. I like the handle better. I was reading on one forum just recently about the handle from Yaqi. It's a longer handle, and people seem to really like the longer handle. Now, Yaqi does not cover the blade tabs, or they cover the blade corners a little bit more. So I'm having a harder time right here. I'm having actually a hard, because I can use that corner with the shield razor to shave around my ears, whereas on the Yaqi, I can't. You can see the blade corners are a little bit more protected. So you're not going to accidentally catch a corner, which is nice. But on the same time, I'm not able to utilize that corner in some of my tricky spots on my head. And so it makes it a little bit more like tedious. I have to kind of go back and forth. Again, the Yaqi, the shield and the Yaqi are similar, but they are different. The head cap of the Yaqi is smaller, so I'm actually able to get close to that surface before the shaving starts, which I enjoy. It lets me really dial in the angle, but that angle is different and it's a little bit more complex, a little more challenging right here. I'm actually having to go back over this area, which I did not have to with the shield, to get it as close because I'm not able to utilize that corner. Just something to note. Just something to note, the shave has been effortless. It's been very easy and it has been very smooth. I think when people talk about Artist Club razors, right, that have never used one, I think that's what comes up constantly is they are very smooth and they are very, very, very close. Easy to get an extremely enjoyable BBS shave with zero passes, right? Very, very few passes, very comfortable. Talk about an underneath the rainbow pot of gold kind of shave. You ask me, very, very close. Very, very enjoyable, and 100% under $100 for both, right? Either one of these can be had for under $100, which I like. Now, again, if you're really, really wanting to support the company that created the original design, right, the innovators in the space, Blackland's 100% the company to go with. But if you're looking at razors that are going to hit the price point, I think just a little bit better, right? In my opinion, they're not going to get on the couch, but they shave really well and they don't bind up blades. They have some innovations. And I feel like, you know, the Blackland Vector's been around for years and years and years, right? We are now seeing razors come out that kind of imitate, but then innovate on top of the design. I like this. I like both of these razors a lot. Again, that is a personal thing. And this is a heated topic, right? I'm going to try to avoid having too many tortures and people angry. Really, honestly, is I think people should choose the razor that they like and that works for them, regardless of price, right? That's just a personal perspective here. I think if a razor works really well for you, who cares? That's my perspective. I like both of these. I think both of these are better for me and my skin needs than other alternatives on the market. That includes the Hawk, that includes, you know, the Claymore. I like the head shape of these. I like the design of these. Let's get relathered up really quick and we'll do a battle pass and see if they can take anything off of each other's side. Come with me. Man, that was difficult to lather with my head as smooth as it is. These razors give such a great shave. My head's so close. I had a hard time relathering up for the battle pass. Let's do it. Let's grab the Yaqi Remulus, the Romulus, whichever version you have. And let's get some passes done here and see if we can take anything off. You can see the lather just come right off, just glistening. I love this ultimate base. You can see here though, no, nothing coming off in that lather at all. We got such a close shave. We got such a smoking close shave that I just do not think that anything ever is going to grow on my head again. It is stinking close, really comfortable, very, very nice. Again, you can see here, nothing coming off. Again, beautiful razor from Yaqi. Fantastic, really close, really enjoyable. Very, very, very nice. Again, I like both designs here. I just think that the Yaqi has got a little bit less of an aggressive feeling than the shield. I want to call that out. It does have less blade feel to me. And I feel like this razor is a razor that really wants to operate at like the 30, probably the 28, 25. It's weird. It's a different angle for sure. Really, really enjoying this one. I really, really like this razor a lot. The heft of it's nice. This, I think this is the sweet spot for heft and size. And I do like the grip. The grip for me is much better than their original design. We're grabbing ourselves a shield here and we're gonna try the same thing. If we can get anything off of the Yaqi side. For the Yaqi side of things, it's also extremely smooth. Very, very comfortable. Very, very close. Very, very nice. I am feeling like the razor's taking something off. Like I feel like it's cutting. right? I feel like something does come off, but then when you check the leather, that's what I kept seeing on my face too. Like it feels like it's biting, but then there's nothing in there. You see that? There's like no stubble in the, or no stubble in the lather. It's weird. It feels like I can feel something, but then as I'm shaving, right, I actually can't see anything in the lather. It's odd. I can almost hear the razor against the skin. And I think that's just the nature of the Shaveart product because it has got more gap and more bite to it, right? You can definitely feel it and hear it. But as far as it cutting and actually giving me a shave, okay, I was able to get a little bit off. Just a little, I may have missed a spot on my neck, but at the same time, that's kind of how it felt on my neck too. Like just, I felt like it was taking a little bit off, a little smudgery, just didn't have enough space to actually show the stubble coming off. Perfectly smooth. Absolutely beautiful shave, 100% to the bone. Wow, I like both razors. I like the price point, I like the format, and I actually think that both razor specs are fantastic. I think they've really come a long way from what they were producing years ago. Really, really comfortable. Oh, both razors. You'd be remiss to say either one is bad razor. Boy, do those shave really well. I really enjoyed this. Thank you again for being here for it. If this is a razor that you've been looking at, if you've been comparing the specs and wanted to see them shave side by side, I hope you found this useful. On the face, I feel like the extra angle from the shield is an advantage, especially in places around your Adam's apple, around my ears. I like that extra little bit of gap in the corner to really get the hard spots. But if you're looking for a razor that is Autopilot Artist Club razor that is super easy, right? I think the Yaqi is actually the one I would choose. The Yaqi for me feels like a razor that's very friendly, whereas I feel like the Shield's also friendly, but more friendly towards an advanced technique. Whereas the Yaqi is going to perform well even with some pressing and some probably improper form. It's a very, very smooth, very, very close shaver for the amount of blade feel you're getting, which is about zero. I do feel like both razors are catering to two different people, two different shavers. And I do think that they shave differently enough that you should know which one to choose for you. Again, mild, very easy Autopilot Artist Club, less Autopilot, but still fairly mild, more blade exposed. So you have more ability to shave in tight spots. And overall, I think both razors absolutely beautiful. I love them. Awesome shave today again with the Mafioso's Retreat. Just love this one. I almost call it the Reform. The Mafioso's Retreat. Really, really enjoy the pineapple note to that with the ozone layering. Awesome. Thank you again for being here for this shave. Oh, we're going to grab ourselves a little Vita, splash it on and see how we did. I'm telling you, either or for the razors, either or, going to do awesome. Going to work for most people looking for an Artist Club shave. Oh, it's good. It is absolutely to the bone close. Super nice. No nicks, no dings, no issues whatsoever. No splotchiness, no redness. Ah, just beautifully close skin, ready to be shown off. Thank you again for being here. I'm going to get out and enjoy an absolutely flawless BBS shave. And hopefully when I see you guys in the next one, you can give me your updates with the two razors that you've purchased. Thank you guys so much again for being here. I'll see you in the next one. Subs out.